before we start with the last point, the branches of pterygopteran ganglion, the posterior wall of the pterygopteran fossa will have three communications, very important. So this is pterygopteran fossa, in which pterygopteran ganglion is there, posterior wall, three communications from lateral to medial. The first communication will be, this will be foramen rotundum, through which maxillary nerve will enter. Second communication will be the pterygoid canal, through which the artery of pterygoid canal will enter, along with that nerve to pterygoid canal. It will enter the pterygopteran fossa. And third communication will be the palatino-vaginal canal. Palatino-vaginal or palatino-vaginal canal, through which pharyngeal nerves and vessels will enter. So through these three communications, pterygopteran fossa will communicate posteriorly through these three communications. And through these three, lateral to medial, first maxillary nerve will enter, second the pterygoid nerve to pterygoid canal or artery to pterygoid canal will enter, and third pharyngeal nerves and vessels will enter. And remember, these will be the same, they will communicate with pterygopteran ganglion. They are the branches of pterygopteran ganglion only. Now we start with the branches. Branches of pterygopteran ganglion will be, I will rub this, and in the branches, the first branches will be orbital. So first pterygopteran ganglion, and here draw this ganglion in this way, and let me make the first branch as orbital. Orbital branches, what will they supply? Remember, they will supply the periosteum of the orbit, they will supply orbitalis muscle, they will supply the sphenoidal sinus, and they will supply the posterior ethmoidal sinus. These are the branches being supplied by orbital branches of pterygopteran ganglion. Second set of branches we draw here, and they are known as palatine branches. Two canals are there, greater palatine canal and lesser palatine canal. So both the canals will open on the surface of hard palate as greater palatine foramen and lesser palatine foramen. So therefore, these palatine branches will divide into greater palatine nerve and lesser palatine nerve. Greater palatine nerve will supply, see here, greater palatine nerve will supply the hard palate. It will pass outside through greater palatine foramen, supply hard palate. At the same time, this greater palatine nerve will also supply a part of the lateral wall of the nose, and it will supply the posterior segment of inferior meatus of the lateral wall of the nose. So therefore, it will supply the posterior inferior nasal branch, where it will supply the posterior part of the area of inferior meatus, because the anterior part of the area of inferior meatus is supplied by, in the previous segment, anterior inferior alveolar nerve, and the posterior part, that is supplied by posterior inferior nasal branch, supplying the area of posterior part of inferior meatus from greater palatine nerve. Then lesser palatine nerve will supply, very important, this lesser palatine nerve will supply tonsils, palatine tonsils, and it will also supply soft palate. And at the same time, please note down, this is also asked in MCQs or Viva, taste fibers from the palate, the entire taste fibers from the palate, gustatory fibers, will pass through lesser palatine nerves. But how it will pass? It will pass through lesser palatine nerve through the pterygopalatine ganglion, through the nerve to pterygoid canal, through greater petrosal nerve and relaying geniculate ganglion of facial nerve. So where is the cell body located? In the geniculate ganglion. And how does the taste fibers from the palate, from the soft palate, reach there? Through lesser palatine nerves, retro. If you trace it retro, it will pass through the palatine nerves, through maxillary, through the nerve to pterygoid canal, through greater petrosal nerve and relay into the greater, the petrosal portion of the facial nerve. And that will be the presence of cell body for the gustatory fibers coming from lesser palatine nerve, that is the palate. So in the greater petrosal nerve will be geniculate ganglion, and that geniculate ganglion is the ganglion of facial nerve where the cell bodies are present. This much is about second palatine branches. Third, first was orbital branches, second were palatine branches, greater palatine, lesser palatine. Now third branch will be again very important. They are known as the posterior superior lateral nasal and posterior superior medial nasal branches. So in short, they will be known as, for example here we will make it at this level, they will be known as nasal branches. So these nasal branches are divided into, very simple, number one, it is divided into posterior superior lateral nasal. Where will it supply? Upper quadrant of the lateral wall of the nose, and it will supply the area till middle meatus, superior concha, middle meatus, middle concha. And posterior superior quadrant, posterior superior lateral nasal branch. Then second branch will be, the second branch will be from here, the second branch will be posterior superior medial nasal branch. Where does it supply? Upper part of posterior segment of nasal septum, posterior superior medial nasal branch. So both these branches are nasal, third division. So first was orbital branches, second was palatine branches, third were nasal branches, and fourth, final branch. This final branch, I will put an arrow here, and it will be known as the fourth branch, which is called pharyngeal nerve. So this pharyngeal nerve will pass through palatovaginal canal, and it will supply the area of nasopharynx. Which area? Behind the opening of auditory tube, tubal opening of auditory tube, area of nasopharynx. Here we finish the fourth branch, pharyngeal branch. So these are the branches of pterygo, palatine ganglion, orbital branches, palatine branches, the nasal branches and the pharyngeal branch. With this we finish the entire pterygo palatine ganglion. Thank you very much.